going to be a difficult lecture because now it's introducing physics into the mix, okay? There is a law, a physics law. That's it. It's a law, okay? And it's called the second law of thermodynamics. And according to the second law of thermodynamics is that the reason why we die, basically, all right, is because all systems are, there is a principle of disorganization. They go into a disorganization that leads to entropy, and entropy is death. Okay, this is a law of physics. So having to, you see what we're getting here is that we are done, we're gonna eventually gonna die because of this law of physics. All right, as a gestalt, we're gonna have to disorganize eventually, and as you disorganize, the eventual goal, the eventual result is gonna be death, okay?
咁佢呢度就講一個定理啦，即係翻翻去佢話講翻翻去讀書嗰陣時講物理嘅嘢。咁佢頭先都講咗，其實今堂咧係比較深嘅，係需要有翻啲物理啊、學嗰方面嘅知識。如果有咩唔明咧，大家可以隨時問咗。咁佢呢度咧就係講關於時間上面咧，佢哋有一個叫做 thermodynamic 係温度流動嘅第二嘅定律啦。佢就話。 點解所有啲複雜複合體咧，好似動物啊或者人啊咁樣唔可以翻翻得去以前咧？就係因為呢個定律咧係講咗咧係會有一個呢啲、這個組織咧係會逐漸會變得混亂啊，所以係唔可以翻翻去以前嗰度。
Okay, that's the next slide. So according to the second law of thermodynamics, entropy increases with time. Okay, this is, but I already said that, but now you can see it on the slide. So as entropy increases, disorganization increases, leading to eventually deterioration and death. So second law of thermodynamics says that with time, entropy increases. It does not decrease, unfortunately, it increases. Therefore, we go from birth to death. And this is because of this second law of thermodynamics. Luckily, when you go into the molecular level, that it doesn't work like that. You'll see how it's a whole different situation. Okay, next slide.
Okay, sorry.
Oh yeah, you wanna say?
Entropy, I'm not sure. 即係你諗下，如果係一個好整齊嘅嘢，一到時間一過咧，佢就慢慢會混亂㗎。而呢個混亂咧，係令到呢個複合嘅生物體咧，慢慢會整體會變得惡化，最後咧無限死亡。Okay.
好，okay, so now why is it that we cannot go back in time? This is a bit, you know, if you're interested in anti-aging, you should be very, very interested in this very important question. Because there's no point, I mean, you know, yeah, we can fake beauty and we can fake aging, but we cannot really, if we want to go back in time, we really want real anti-aging. How can we achieve that? Because it is possible. So our bodies consist of interacting integrated layers from cells, to vital organs, to muscles, to body parts, working together. And that forms a gestalt, okay? And that's life, that's you, me, whatever, each one of you in this room. Now, if entropy increases with time, you cannot go back in time, right? Because it will increase whether time goes backwards or forwards, if entropy increases. So stepping back in time will throw us into an unknown chaos of disorder with no guarantee of maintaining our present integration. So you become a gestalt, all right? So if you're born and you're born as a gestalt, as a whole person with a personality, with a concept, with beliefs, with being different than everyone else. You're unique, right? And that unique gestalt cannot go back in time, because once you disorganize that, then you know you can never find that same gestalt. You see what I mean? Because the connections are so complex. Are you understanding me? It's easy, but it's complex to understand. Because you're a gestalt, once you're disorganized, it's like saying I have a very beautiful, look at Michael Jackson, okay? He wants to look white. So what he did, he made his skin white, and he changed his nose to look like a white person, and he ended up looking like a monster. Why? Because he, you know, even there, it's not possible. Do you see what I mean? He could not make himself white, no matter how much money he had. He had just ended up making himself look weird. Do you see what I'm trying to tell you? We cannot do it with plastic surgery. We cannot do it with any other way. There's only one way we can do it, and that's through molecular mechanisms, as we're going to find out shortly.
Okay.他剛才做了他們之前講最主要就是因為我們人是一個非常複合的整體來的，譬如說我們身體有不同的器官，我們不同的器官實際上是由很多細胞而組成的嘛，那些細胞一定要互相協調到才發揮到一個正常的功能的，這個就是因為這樣而那個逐步走向混亂的定律之下，所以人體是不會只會慢慢慢慢會老化。所以如果你要明白真正的抗衰老，一定要明白呢一樣嘢。只有在分子生物學上咧，先至唔會有呢個影響嘅，因為人很複雜。就好似佢頭先舉咗例咧，就係、Michael Jackson， 無論佢點樣想變漂白啊，點樣整咧，佢都唔會變成白人，因為我哋人係整體好複雜嘅。譬如我而家一講一句嘢，其實係好多樣嘢加埋，有腦啊、聲啊、肌肉啊、神經啊、血管啊，所有樣嘢加加埋埋。
Okay, let's go. Okay. Now, what the bottom line of this principle, of the Gestalt principle, is that once you reach an individual, a Gestalt, then there is a resistance to change. When I got the second doctorate in clinical psychology, I was working in hospitals with mentally ill patients. The one thing that I noticed is that these people don't want to change. So why don't they want to get better? There is a resistance, and that resistance has to do with homeostasis. It has to do with the stability of personality. So you get married and your wife is trying to make you change, right? What's going to happen? You're not going to change. Or, you know, your husband is trying to make you change and you pretend you're changing, but really you're not going to change. Why? Because there is a resistance of your personality to change. That resistance to change, it has to be there, otherwise every day you would be a different person. You have to have a resistance. It's a stability. It's a sense of stability. If I have a lecture every day, you're gonna come in and you're gonna sit on the same seat that you sat before. Why? There's a stability into the things that you do every day. You wake up and you do the same things every day. That stability is what we call the gestalt, is you, is a gestalt. And that is, there is a resistance in that, it's ingrained in that gestalt. And that's why change is so difficult. If change is difficult, if your wife or your husband cannot change you, how are you gonna go back in time just like that? Hello, it's not gonna happen, okay? So that gestalt that makes an individual and that's why people that are very ill, they cannot get well, they get worse. And people that are well, they don't get ill that easily. So that is a resistance. It's homeostasis is for good and it's for bad. You know, it's a good thing and there's a bad thing. But people that are physically ill or psychologically ill, they don't want to get better. And that's, hi, Dr. Kwok, please come in. And that's the resistance of it's homeostasis or a gestalt. And it's a point to it. We need the homeostasis to have stability. Okay, let's have the next. So now you understand a little better. Okay, let's move on. Okay. So, however, time reversal is absolutely common practice in molecular mechanisms. It's the basis of our Hi Fendi, and we're going to be doing it in Chinese too, so you can understand. So time reversal is the basis for our body's molecular repair operations. So all molecular energy production, all of our energy, all of our molecular mechanisms reverse time. They basically take a phosphate, they give out a phosphate, and they go back and forth in time. And we're going to see this in a second. Let's move on to the next. Oh, you want to explain that?
其實剛才我講這張，其實剛才講到整體上我們不可以時間逆轉，但是在我們身體裏面，我們每個細胞都在做一些時間逆轉的東西，例如在我們細胞產生能量的時候，就會將那些分子的加元再減，再還原，總之是一個循環，但是我們整體上是做不到的，但是在分子
Okay, so bottom line, if anti-aging is time reversal, we cannot do it with whole persons, but we can do it in the molecular level with molecular mechanisms. So anti-aging has to focus on molecular mechanisms if we can have a chance for time reversal. And this is a very, very interesting. So what is a free radical? A free radical is a stable molecule that has lost one electron. So it has an odd number of electrons rather than an even number of electrons. If you give this free radical its missing electron, it turns back into being a stable molecule. So here is a very plain and straightforward time reversal. I'm a stable molecule, I turn into a free radical, I'm given an electron and I'm turning back into a stable molecule. Complete time reversal, just depending on one electron. Okay?